beautiful and welcome back to my channel and welcome to this video where we're going to try out the new 5 pen palettes by Colourpop. These, the more colourful ones, because I have all 5 of them here, and we're just going to see if these are worth getting. We're also going to compare them a bit, just to the 9 pen monochromatic palettes, and see if they are like the same thing. Because you don't want to get double. It's always nice to have something to choose from in your collection, to not just have like the one thing, but we don't need to buy dupes. Let me be that one. I'll try everything so that you don't have to. We're gonna do an eye look, we're gonna do swatches, we're gonna compare these palettes, and yeah, let's just see if these are anything worth picking up. And if you haven't been here before, my name's Angie. Hello, I am a lover of fashion and makeup, especially colorful things, so these palettes are pretty much up my alley. And if you want to see some more color on your timeline, if you want to see some more fun makeup tutorials, reviews, hauls, makeup commentary, don't forget to subscribe because I upload 5 videos a week. If you've been to my channel before, you actually know that I did buy these palettes myself. I bought these palettes from Colourpop when they launched. You could buy a full bundle or you could buy them for $10 each. I don't remember what the bundle was, but I'm pretty sure I like saved a dollar or so. But then Colourpop ended up sending these to me in PR as well. So I have doubles. I was thinking we're gonna have a bit of a... I wanna have a 100k giveaway. Maybe I'll set that up. I'll see if I can set that up for next week, so don't forget to subscribe to be part of that as well, because I just recently hit 100k, and I'll see if I can set that up, maybe towards the end of this week or next week, something like that. But I'll have a giveaway where I'll give away the 5 extras, because I obviously do not need doubles. We're gonna create an eye look. I'm gonna pull from all of these to make an eye look, but if you want to see more like dedicated videos on each and every one of these, let me know, because I usually go with like the views. Whatever gets a lot of views tells me that that is the thing that you're interested in, that is the thing that you are clicking on. I think that that is how most YouTubers like gosh like interest, just by like seeing what garners the most views, because that is the thing that you chose to click on. So obviously you were interested. Let's have a closer look at all of these. So let's start with the one that, when I bought this, this would be my favorite because I love blue eyeshadow. And this is the one that's called Rumor Has It. These are 5 pans, and I will say to make this palette more perfect for me, this would have had one of the matte blues, would have been a darker navy blue, because I love deepening up a look. But I will say I love the tone of all of these shadows, and this is not that similar to the Blue Moon, because this one has 2 more turquoisey minty shades, together with 3 of the more like Klein blue, like more traditional blues, so to speak. So I like the divide between the minty and the blue. I think that this is a nice divide. I will say that it's not that different between these two. So I kind of wish that one of these would have been switched out for something deeper, because that's my preference, but it's not that big of a deal. Like I'll survive, but we'll definitely be using at least one of the shades from this palette, because I love a good blue one. Oh, let me show you the packaging as well. The packaging of these 5 pans are beautiful, like a luxurious tapestry kind of a thing, and some of these shadows do have imprints of the French lily, so there's like one imprint in each palette that like comes together with the paper packaging of these palettes. Very pretty. The next one is the one that's called Cashmere Forever. This is the purpley one. I think that when I look at these now, this is probably the one that I like the best, because this one has 2 very light shades. It has 1 deeper shade and 1 deeper, like a deeper matte and a deeper shimmer, and then it has like a mid-tone true purple. I did compare this palette both to the Lilac You A Lot and the It's My Pleasure. These are the 9 pan palettes in the purple. They have one that's more like a cool tone purple lavender side, and then the other monochromatic purple palette from Colourpop, the It's My Pleasure, it's more of the berry toned one, and I feel like this is a mix of both of those, but just very condensed. So I kind of like how this looks. I think that this looks really pretty. This softy here is a beautiful like lavender, very like shiny shade. I'm very impressed with how this one looks. So I think just out of like looking at them, I haven't used them yet, but just by looking at them, I think that this is my favorite, but I love the tones in the blue one as well. The next one is the one that's a pink and red mix, and you know I love a pink and red mix. I'm not 100% sure that I will be able to get the contrast that I like with this palette, but I do think that you will be able to create a really nice, striking red and pink look with this one. I am very intrigued to see how this one is on the eyes. In the pan, the True Ivy and the Lol No, the 2 shimmery pinks, are pretty similar. I mean, this is more of a gold pink and this is more of a true Barbie pink shimmer, but still, I kind of wish that one of these would have been a little bit either deeper or lighter, just to have a bit more contrast in the palette. I compared this to the Ooh La La palette, which is the 9 Pan palette, and I would say that this is not similar to that one at all, because the monochromatic pink palette, the 9 Pan from Colourpop, is actually not that monochromatic. It is a mix of pinks and purples, and this is instead a mix of red and pink. So they're not that similar. I would say maybe I should have probably compared this to the Strawberry Shake instead, because that one is a pink and red, so maybe this is more similar to that one, if we're gonna be totally honest. Do you remember that one? It's the Strawberry Shake or the Strawberry Milkshake. Maybe this one is actually more similar to that. Yeah, this is more of a pink with a pop of red, and the Ooh La La is more of a pink with a pop of purple. I hope this makes sense. I will say, I do really like the look of the green one as well. It's called High Society. This one also looks really nice, but maybe this one is sharing spaces with the purple one, because I will be honest, this looks really pretty. It does depend a little bit how the scene looks on the eyes though, if it is enough to create some dimension on the eyes. If this is enough to create some dimension on the eyes, because the purple one does look a little deeper, I think that this could be a real hit. It has a really nice array of greens, and this is not that similar to the Just My Luck. I will say the only one that's really similar is this like lime green shimmer that both of the palettes have. This one is more of a warmer green, and the Just My Luck is more of a cooler green. So they are similar, yes, but I don't think you'll get the same tone on the eyes. This all depends on like how much do you love greens. Do you think that green is a green is a green, or do you think that there's like not all greens are created equal? Because I think that this is more of a warm green palette, but I really do like the look of this. I think it's really pretty, and I love small palettes, so for me, having more small palettes, it's only something positive. The last one is Statement Piece, and first when I was comparing this, I was looking, I was like, oh yeah, and this is the red one, but actually, this is more of an orange peach one. So I compared this one to the Orange You Glad, which is the orangey monochromatic palette. I think that this one is probably the one that's the least different from any of the monochromatic palettes that I have, the 9 Pans from Colourpop, because some of the monochromatic palettes from Colourpop aren't even, like, let me rephrase that. Some of the 9 Pan palettes that people are calling monochromatic palettes aren't even monochromatic palettes. To be fair, not even the Ooh La La that's meant to be the pink one is a monochromatic palette. I would say that the one that they came out with, the Candy Floss theme, is more of a monochromatic pink palette than the Ooh La La is. But I compared this to the orange one because at least it is leaning a little bit that orangey coral. But yeah, this is really pretty. It's like a peach palette with a pop of a super, super bright orange that almost is as orange, so it's leaning a little bit red. So I think that is a really nice pop. And I think that with this one and this one, you will be able to get a really nice contrasty, everyday, bright, fun look. I am very excited about this one as well. For me, it is lacking a bit of depth, but I will say that when it comes to summer and spring, I do like a softer but still colorful look, just with some mascara and gloss to go out the door. So I feel like this palette could be perfect for that, because I am still in love with orange eyeshadows, even though this one is maybe a bit more peachy. But yeah, I hope this was helpful. Like I said, when I'm filming this part, I haven't swatched or touched this or done anything. You've seen the swatches now, but I'm gonna do my first impression now. I'm gonna put some eye primer on. I'm gonna use the Juvia's Place Prep and Prime. Eye Prep by Prime eye primer. Really been enjoying this one. I'm gonna use it in two, because I'm gonna be trying to play a little bit with negative space so I can use as many of these shadows as possible. That is what I'm planning. So let's zoom in, let me put some primer on, and then we can create something, because I have big, big plans for my eye look today. As you can see, this eye primer is pretty much like my skin color. So I think that this will be perfect also to cut out my crease and create a bit of a negative space, because it is so true to like my skin color, at least where it's at right now. So what I want to do is I want to do a rainbow cut crease, and I want to do a rainbow low lash line, and I want to have some negative space and then play with some of the shimmers on the lip. That is my plan. So how am I doing that? I think I'm gonna do blue, purple, wait. Green, blue, purple, pink, peach. Okay, this is the plan. So I'm starting with green. Wow. wow, that took some time. And I'm not gonna do a half cut crease today. I'm gonna do like a full cut crease. This is the plan. This is the plan. I'm starting with the dark green, I guess. And I've had some green on this brush before, so I think it's gonna be fine. I am starting out here. And I'm gonna cut this later, so I'm not that concerned with the lower part. When you're doing looks like this, it's nice to just shape things first. Like, how do I want this to be? And I want the green to be out here. And I want to be able to blend a bit. So I'm using the little lighter green, and I'm just gonna put that. I'm trying to use as little as possible above. Again, not too concerned with this line here, because we are gonna clean that up in a little bit. I am just blending with the lighter green now. Okay, now I'm gonna go in with the blue, and I guess I'm using this one then. And I might try and blend it out a bit with the minty one. My dog is making a lot of noises. If you are wondering what the fluff is that noise, it is my dog. He loves to sleep next to me when I'm doing my makeup. I guess he like wants to be closer. This was a bit darker than the green, so I'm taking some of the minty shade now and just blending on top so we don't end up getting it too dark here. Again, we will fix this in a bit. I might go in with a little bit more of the green and just make this a little more defined, because this blue was a little darker. Because it's always nice for things to be, at least for me, and for me and how I like my makeup, I like things to be a little darker out here. I think I'm gonna do this one, not the darkest purple, but like the mid-tone purple. And I'm just putting some here to be a little bit of a, ooh, that's a nice tone, to be a little bit of a bridge between the shades to come. And I'll just go over a little bit with the lavender one, the one that's a lighter. You can see that this is precision, and I'm not making like wide strokes, because when you're doing looks like this, precision is needed. Let me tell you, precision is needed. Is it time to go in with the pink then? I want to use this one. I want to use this one, and again, ooh, that is pretty. I'm not using the darkest shade because I'm trying to soften this up a bit as I go into the inner corners. Just blending in with the purple a bit so it looks a little bit more seamless. And I'm gonna end up with the lightest of the peaches, which is this one here. And I'm gonna end up with that one. And I'm taking that down here to end in like my inner corners. Of course, I've only done this on one eye now, but I'm gonna take a little Q-tip, and I'm gonna see if I can get some makeup remover. Do I have any here? Let me get some micellar water and just crisp this line up so that I can cut it. But I need to get it because I have it in my bathroom. Since I didn't set the eye primer here, it's also creased a bit. But just with a Q-tip that has a little bit of micellar water, you see I'm just crisping up the line a little bit, and I'm gonna cut it afterwards. But if I cut it before crisping up the line, there is a risk, I'm not gonna get that negative space that I'm after, because there's gonna be too much color that mixes with the primer. So it's nice to clean up a little bit before if you're doing negative space. So you don't end up getting color mixed in the primer. I'm taking a little bit of the primer now on this flat brush that's like pretty slim. This one is from NYX. And now I am again painting on some primer, but I'm trying to crisp up this line now so that we can have... You see that negative space. I'm gonna try and perfect this a bit, because I have a bit of crinkly eyelids, and sometimes you need to really look at this a bit closer and be a bit precise. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do my normal under eye setting powder, and I'm taking that on the same brush, and I'm just setting the line with that powder, because I'm not gonna put eyeshadow on that line. I'm not dragging it down any further, I'm just putting it on the line. Okay, this is where I'm at right now. I actually used one of the new... Did I lose it already? Here it is. One of the new OPB Beauty liners. This is in 902. Just to do a little shimmy shimmy on the line to create the line. The border. So, we are gonna do some of the shimmers on the lid. And I'm thinking we'll maybe not do this one. We'll just do the pink, purple, because the pink and the coral shimmer are gonna be so similar. So maybe I'll just do pink, purple, blue, green. Oh, and I wanna do the matte on the... Listen, this is gonna be fantastic. I love how I'm just boosting myself up. But I'm taking the pink in the middle, this one here. I'm just, so far, I think that these have been nice ColourPop eyeshadows. I will of course have to, where did I put the spray? I will of course have to try these a bit more to see if you can like do proper blends and if you can build them and blah blah blah. I'm just here to try a couple of them. I am spraying so that I can have this be as precise as possible because I want to be able to not fill this out but leave a negative space here. Do you see? So I'm doing the pink on the lid. I love how this fold is just eating everything up. But I'm doing the lid and I'm leaving the line. I think my lids are a little too old to get away with this negative space, but it is what it is. And then I'm gonna take I want to take this one because it's so pretty. Let's see how that one looks, if it's possible, or maybe I need to mix them. Yeah, you know what I'm doing? I am mixing the two. I'm mixing the two purple shimmers. Remember, you can always mix and match. See, you're getting something that's a little bit more purple. Maybe I'll use a little bit more of the darker one. I just didn't want it to be super dark. And again, leaving that negative space, maybe I'll do a little bit more of the dark one so we can get a bit of definition. And then it's time for the blue. So I'm using the one that's more of a true blue. As you can see, I chose the one that's a little bit more of a lime because I felt like I wanted to have that moment, and I'm just following the line a little bit and just dragging this out. I will use a liner on my like lash line as well to just define this a bit, but I'm just dragging this out a little bit and following the line a little, and I'm gonna meet up with the shadows under my eyes afterwards as well. I'm going to use a little bit of this nude liner by Makeup Geek, both on my lash line and under my eyes, so that the shadows have something to stick to, since I powdered under my eyes, so that I can get the same like intensity under my eyes as I have on top. And I am going to use the same matte shadows as I used on top in the same order. And yeah, I'm going to just finish it up like that with the same shadows. And then I am gonna do some mascara, do a little bit of liner, and I think that that's gonna be it. Oh, this is so pretty. I'm literally just plopping this on. But I mean, you can see how cool this is. And then the last one is the green. I'm mixing a little bit the lighter and the darker. And now, like I said, I'm gonna drag this a little bit out so that we have the same and they can meet here. Do you see what I mean? I'm using a little bit of the lighter and just... So yeah, I mean, it's a lot, it's a lot. I recognize the fact that this is a lot, but it's also a lot of fun. Okay, let me do some mascara and some liner, and you know what, let me pop on some lashes as well, because this is the kind of look that I would never wear without lashes. So let me finish this up, and I can show you the finished look, and I'll give you some final thoughts about these palettes. Okay, so I think that that is everything. I think everything is done. What do you think? I mean, it's a bit crazy. I know it's a bit crazy, but I also really like it. I like having a bit of a crazy eye look. I think it's fun to sometimes just sit down and do something really intricate and just something fun. Is this the most flattering makeup look? No. But is it fun? Yeah, it's super fun and it was fun to do. So what do I feel about these palettes? If you have all the 9 pan palettes like I do, to be honest, I think I have most of them, you do not need these because most of these shades or something, at least something similar, are represented in those palettes. Trust me on that one. The one that I feel is the most different would be the green one, because this is more of a warm green and the Just My Luck is a bit more of a cooler tone green with that lime. But they're all still very, very similar. Are they dead on dupes? No, they're definitely not dead on dupes. Maybe actually this one is the most like different one because it's like a peach with an orange. But I will say, if you have the 9 pan palettes from ColourPop, you have these. What I think is the most interesting with this is not only because they're smaller, and I love a small palette. Hopefully I'm going to be vaccinated soon and I'll be able to travel a bit again, because you know that I am a huge fan of traveling and I cannot wait to just experience more places and experience more people and just things. But these are the perfect kind of thing to bring traveling, because I love picking like 2 or 3 smaller palettes when traveling, and this is the perfect thing for me. And what I also think is, the thing that I didn't really see until I had them with me, is that these are not monochromatic palettes, because this is peaches and an orange. This one is pinks and a red. This one is 2 turquoises and like 2 mints and 3 blues. This one is a mix of berries, like more berry purple and more like lavender purple. And this one is a monochromatic palette. This one is a green monochromatic palette. There's nothing else but green in this. But again, this is the most different one from the monochromatic 9 pan. So I think that it seems like they had some kind of a thought with this. And I feel and I hope that this kind of color combo can be something for the future, because I would love... Listen, hear me out. What if you had something like this and it's 3 swampy greens, a purple and a yellow? Like, I would love that. Color combos like that, can we have that? Please, pretty please, with the cherry on top. I feel like the quality is, from what I've tried right now, like the normal ColourPop quality. Of course, I will try them more in more like traditional techniques just to make sure that I'm not lying to you. But right now, I feel like they're the typical ColourPop shadow quality. I don't feel like any of these felt different. I will say that like when it comes to the shimmers, I will feel like the only shimmer that was really like... These are like true satins, I would say. Maybe this one is a little bit more high impact. It's also the one that I have in my inner corners. But I don't feel like any of these are like the molten, like glide metallic formula. They're traditional shimmers, but they are good traditional shimmers. And that is my opinion. If you have any questions about anything that I am wearing, the things that I use, the things that I already had on my face when I started this video, everything is always in the description box, together with my codes and links and socials and all of that. So check the description box for more info. Do not forget to subscribe, because I will have a video tomorrow as well. And if you want to hear more about these, I will for sure be touching on them again in my review roundup that I do monthly once I've been able to try these things a bit more. Now let me know your thoughts down below, and I will see you tomorrow in a new video.